And it's important, I think, for us to understand. When I sat back and started thinking about Boston and other inner cities, is that most of the people that we all drink from and have the luxury of drinking in their talent and wisdom, such as Guru, Gangsta, Edo G and the Bulldogs, Bobby Brown, all of these people came, most of them came from environments like this. This is where the real people are, and this is where we need to be. Shout out to Boston. Shout out to Boston.
That's the heat, baby.
It's time to sit and think before we hit the brink. Locker room at a prize fight before we hit the ring. Like when I tell these corporate leeches they can't get a thing, or when I tell relentless rappers they had better sing. The position that anyone holds could be up to grabs. I'm waiting up the app to see if anyone folds. Since I was 21 years old and legal, I knew the difference between gimmicky gangsters and powerful people. I'm the reason why the game is flipped. I'm the reason why your aim is missed. I'm the reason why you're mad I only sprain my wrist. The reason my mind frame is trained in this. You like on fire? Better acquire the taste. Cause you walk around with 4 pounds by the waist. Deface property, then be laced properly. Rules are rules, fools are fools, I react logically. Ain't no way, so come, make my day. Like Tom Hanks, I earn long bank and cast you away. Do away.
It's like in my hand, I'm rolling.
I repeat, this is not a question.
Oh, you bragging about the keys you flip and who you done up, nigga, what up, what up?
Put up or shut
talking
up.
Shit about the chicks and the whips you got. You think you hot?
Hot. Man, you put up or shut
always
up.
Always talking about your dough and your wealth and fame. Use a lame.
Get out of here, put up or shut
you
up.
You got hot beats and kids that can spit mad fire. Use a lie.
That's whack. Put up or shut up.
It's mic in my hand, I'm rolling.
All right, 1, 2, 1, 2. Baba TV Black at you again. Baba Fire Time Every TV. Special treat for you guys. As you know, we are down in my hometown, Boston, Massachusetts, on the ground. Because you know why? We like this street consciousness on Baba TV. We like to capture the realness and the essence of the people. So right now, we're in Bromley Heath Projects, now known as Mildred Haley Projects, and we in one of the oldest housing developments in the country. A lot of history in my city. This project is not exempt of the historical relevancy in this city. Not only is this one of the realest, one of the most notorious projects that bred a lot of gangsters, a lot of street legends, a lot of hustlers, even a lot of revolutionaries. We're looking at one now, right? But it also is one of the first projects in the country that was community run from the 1960s, 70s, community run by the people for the people. I got a representative from the streets, a street soldier here on the ground. Why don't you introduce yourself to the people and give them a little backdrop of who you are and what it is that you do for the platform, my brother.
Hey, man, peace, man. Jurassic Park, man, rap, man, you know this is Scheme Castellano, man, the one and only. If there's another, he's a phony, man. You know what I'm saying? Blessed to be here with these brothers and just put my city on the map, you know what I'm saying? And also my community, you know what I'm saying? Because this isn't just a gang or some type of following, you know, this is our culture, this is our tradition, you know. Everything, you know, when it comes to Boston isn't all Southy and just, you know, the traditional shit that you see out in South Boston, Whitey Bulger. You know, you have a very versatile, you know, ethnic background in our city. And, you know, it's 2021. So, you know, given, you know, my absence from my community just due to dealing with personal, you know, past prior legal issues and just getting caught up in a system, you know what I'm saying, my contribution to my city and my community has been limited. But, you know, as we're here today, I'm trying to utilize this platform, you know, with these brothers that have allowed me to, you know, even just speak on whatever questions that y'all may want to know or may have, other than just, you know, the things that you hear about Boston. Or, you know, it's just a whole bunch of different, you know, platforms and individuals and creativities and minds in our city that just comes from all different walks of life that, you know, we're just here, we're merging, and we're just giving this day, and just, you know, furthermore, you know, like, again, this platform is just, it's so many different parts of Boston, Jamaica Plain, Roxbury, Dorchester, you know, regardless of setting aside, you know, whatever gang issues or whatever, because, you know, our people, we come from tribalism, you know what I'm saying, back from Africa, so wherever you from, whatever you bang, and whatever personal issues, you know, and discrepancies, we all have our issues, but, you know, as mankind and humanity, you know, we trying to, you know, just reconnect this and put this together, man. You know what I'm saying? And whatever I can, you know, contribute to this cause, you know, I'm here, and you know, I'm just trying to be a voice, man. You know, I'm just a simple man and a humble man, you know, but you know, I'm just going to get a mic right here.
And that is real talk, too. That's why I appreciate you. You know what? One of the greatest resources that we have in the community, right? Because we have a lot of creativity. We got a lot of culture. Most hate it, but yet we're most imitated. But one of our greatest resources, one of the most underrepresented and undercultivated resources that we have in the community is our youth.
Right.
Exactly. Our youth is our future. Our future represents our self-preservation. Right. So you being, to me, even though you getting up there in years, brother, you know, I remember you was a little bit younger, a little smaller and stuff. Now you know, just an older warrior in the battlefield. Nonetheless, you're connected with the youth. Right. You know what I'm saying? And our youth are under attack, psychologically, politically, economically, otherwise. And this is nothing new, so it's not like I'm a preach to the flock. But to put my point in perspective and mentioning that is when you have somebody who comes from the element of the social, most socially ignored, you know what I'm saying, politically castrated, absolutely, and economically, you know what I'm saying, impotent type of environment, it produces a social underclass, which harbors a lot of violence, crime, and a low success rate. But now what we're seeing is a lot of these youth is coming up being self-sufficient, entrepreneurs. A lot of people are taking their pain and doing something even with the pen with it. You see a lot of authors coming in the community. A lot of people trying to use that camera and that lens and make movies about their life. A lot of times with a message to positively inspire people with some of the life with negative experiences and lives they've been through. A lot of people are turning positives to negatives. They're turning lemons into lemonade. You know what I'm saying? I think that you're a proponent of that because you're still here. You're still trooping. You're talking wiser. You're looking strong in all your glory. And where you're from and a lot of the soldiers that come from this community, which a lot of them aren't here, unfortunately, you know what I'm saying? The target and the focus got to be the youth. Organizing the youth, which is our greatest resource. And one thing I like about that, see, everybody's not going to come into knowledge through no specific doctrine or school of thought and consciousness. You know what I mean? And that's dope because the community is not just the conscious, the pro-black, the woke folk. The community is the street dude, the soldier, the father that's single, the person trying to find themselves, the person trying to get it together. So we got to cover every dynamic of that in the community. So that's why, like on Baba TV and a platform, we deal with street consciousness once again. We get on the ground and we deal with the people, which a lot of people are not giving a voice to and the people are ignoring. But some of our greatest resources, greatest jewels, greatest creators, greatest future entrepreneurs and power brokers are right here in these communities. Our lost and often misguided warriors, you know what I'm saying, are definitely right here in the community. But you know what I'm saying, we're making a difference by you just talking the way you talk. And I know people are going to be inquisitive to know about what it is that you do. What inspired you? Because I know we come from the street background without talking too much. You know what I'm saying? What inspired you or some of the struggles that you went through, right, in life that made you want to become just more? Definitely going to be hood because we're a product. I'm still a hood. Don't get me wrong. Now, am I involved with illicit activity in the hood? No. But my mannerism, my diddy bop when I walk, you know what I'm saying? Certain language or slanguage and terminology we use is hood.
You can still have your flair and your flavor.
That's right.
And still have growth and project and walk.
And tell the people what inspired you. What's inspiring you?
Well, a lot of things that inspired me as far as just like keeping it honestly, like with myself. You know, I've had a lot of setbacks in my life, a lot of rude awakenings, you know, that transpired in my life that, you know, kind of disrupted, you know, the easygoing flow in my life. So when I found myself in a particular situation where, you know, basically I was cast off. I was a condemned man in the federal institution, you know, for 15 years. I overturned a 15-year bid. You know, I did 8.5 years, you know what I'm saying, for a deuce. So, yeah, for a 22, you know what I'm saying? So this is the injustice of America that, you know, we all have our story, and I don't want to make mine more significant than the next man, because we all have a gut-wrenching, you know, sour-twisting, frowned-upon story in some which way in our walk, in our journey. So, you know, when it comes to just being a lot more polished and just, you know, I just took it upon myself that when I was incarcerated, while I was in there, I just always kind of told myself, like, I don't want to be the same individual that I went in when I come back out. And it's like a drug addict, you know what I'm saying, in recovery, you know what I'm saying? So, you know, coming from the streets, and I'm not a drug addict, just for the record, but, you know, I'm just using that analogy to as, you know, it's one day at a time, like, you know what I'm saying, the temptation, you know, just trying to, you know, function and balance, because, you know, just coming out of those type of particular conditions and situations, as far as just being in the system, they're so cruel and unfair that you're not coming out with no real social skills and tools. And so there were a lot of individuals that don't have this opportunity to be out here and just stand right here on this platform and speak. And, you know, so it's just like, you know, this is my contribution to them, that, you know, they didn't have that opportunity. But because I'm here and I know that, you know what I'm saying, I've seen everything. I've heard so many stories. Even just individuals that, you know, friends and family members, and crossed them and turned them out over money and all type of just come to find out bullshit. It was just like, you know, like these type of stories, you know what I'm saying, had a real eye opener to me, to where it's just like, you know, really just weighing out the consequences as far as just, you know, for every action is a reaction, and, you know, is the risk really worth the reward, you know, as far as just what's coming. So, you know, my father always told me, man, Junior, you're gonna reap the benefits of suffer the consequences behind your actions. So, you know, I mean, everything as far as just moving today as a father, as a brother, as a son, as a cousin, I'm many men, you know what I'm saying? But just like, it's just, you know, I'm trying to better myself, you know what I'm saying? And it's just a day by day process. So just to have this opportunity to be free, it's nice. It's a beautiful day outside. I know I've been in a cell, you know what I'm saying, on days like this, and I didn't have that opportunity. And just everything that's going on now, COVID, I could just imagine just that much more, that foot on the neck that these people just got on us, that it's just that much more pressure. So, you know what I'm saying, just salute to the good men, man, you know, that actually stood tall for this. You're not just faking on social media and whatever the case may be. Like, you know, there's, you know, I don't take nothing away from anybody, but, you know what I'm saying, there's just, you know, battlefield tested individuals that just go unmentioned. And, you know what I'm saying, we're here to say that, you know what I'm saying, we got to start changing and making better decisions just for our people, man, economically as well too.
And to add to my man's beautiful build, I like the way you convey your words. It's to the point, but it's deep. It's simple but deep and very polished. I want to say this too, you know, life is school. We graduate from a physical building called school, right, where it has a curriculum and a certain kind of format and stability in it. We understand that. But that is only preparatory, or should be, for the extended classroom called life, right, where it's called graduating when you get from one phase or degree or level to another. But in school we graduate, it's called gradual or a gradual process. See, but in the extended classroom of life, you know what I'm saying, instead of getting black or getting kept back or you fail, you know what I'm saying, the lessons come in many and a multiplicity and a plethora of other ways. You see what I'm saying? The thing is, are we learning from them lessons? What are we learning from the lessons? And are they helping us to evolve? Because when you're tried by fire, a lot of things, and a lot of, let's liken the struggles that we come from in our environments to fire, you know what I'm saying, which is heat, like the hat you got on, right? So when you're tried by fire, which is heat, the heat, what does it do to you? It burns certain components or elements burn at a higher temperature, and it melts it off. And what you have is, that's how you refine or go through the refining process to get what you have, gold. It has to undergo some heat, some fire, some pressure, some things that it has to undergo in order for it to become polished. So a lot of the struggles that we go through, you know what I'm saying? A lot of the things that we see and observe, a lot of things in the extended classroom of life, we never count ourselves out as a failure. As long as you're living, you're learning, and you know better in order to show better, so you learn to live better. That's what life and the lessons that life brings is all about. You know what I'm saying? It may come in many ways for many people, but depending on how we grow, evolve, and our actions correspond with our growth and development, those are determining factors to how we're succeeding and how we're gradually or graduating or progressing in this extended classroom called life, man. So anything you want to close out, man, you definitely did your thing. Just shout the people out if you got a website, if you got a rap group, anything you want to promote.
Man, shout out to the good men, to the man, Trotty Gang, man. You know, follow me on IG, Scheme Castellano. On Facebook, IG is King Castellano. Snapchat is Castellano Drugs. Castellano spelled C-A-S-T-E-L-L-A-N-O. Like I said, listen, man, just we trying to evolve and polish our ways, man, as a people. And I just hope, you know what I'm saying, that just going from here, if I've just enlightened anybody that sees this interview, and just, you know, whatever you pick up from this, man, like, you know what I'm saying, there's better ways and other alternatives that we can exhaust and just execute in our life. Because, you know, just creating your own identity and just, you know, wanting your own form to just being able to leave your mark just individually for yourself is just like so profound, man, and that's where you create your own legacy. So just, you know what I'm saying, man, just black power, man. And you know what I'm saying, not even on no just, you know, divided type lines, man. You know, black is beautiful, and our people, man, you know, life is beautiful. So you know what I'm saying, we just here and we just trying to just mend these barriers and these bridges, man, in the city and in our community and in the world.
Thank you very much, my brother, Brother Scheme. One of the thoroughest, sharpest young brothers out here, very refined. For him to be the soldier and the warrior he is, he's very humble, but that shows growth and evolution and development and manhood, most importantly. I want to thank you for allowing us to interview you in this segment of Baba TV. But trust me, people out there, this isn't the last you have seen of this brother. All right, so stay tuned, all right, as we travel throughout the city to check out some more of what Boston has to offer right here on Baba TV.